Tonight here on The Rant, our story on the WHAS 1119 team last night brought some comments. Graymore-Devondale police, we just showed you, called to a home where they restrained a teenager with autism with a chokehold as he was having a moment of crisis. We interviewed his mother and talked to the police chief, who said they've made 20 runs to the house and his officers did everything right. Also tonight, the shot at a million incentive being offered by the state for you to get your COVID shot. More than 250,000 people have signed up for a chance at it, but have strong opinions on the offer.
It is so easy to be wasteful when money or any other resource, when it doesn't cost you anything. We have needs in this community, and $1 million would go a long way. People would be happy to get $100 a shot.
Yes, I'm wondering about the $1 million giveaway for getting COVID shots. I think that should be spread out more between more people. A lot of people have went through heck with this COVID.
I'm not understanding these bills completely, but however, we all are God's children and we all are equal. So there is no room to teach any child that one race is greater than the other because they are not.
Hey, this is Andre Goatley from Louisville, Kentucky. Just wanted to congratulate WHAS on another fantastic crusade for children. As a crusade supporter, this brings so much joy to me. Can't wait to help out in 2022.
And what a total. Great to see it again. Tracy in Louisville on the Bills. You heard one of the calls about it by Republicans in Frankfort that would restrict how far teachers can teach racism's history. It's no surprise that the same Republicans who claimed you can't erase history when Confederate statues were being removed are now trying to delete history by not allowing the truth of systemic racism in America be taught. On our story last night about the chokehold restraint by Graymore-Devondale police, Yenny in Louisville, when your teenage autistic child is having an episode, there is no one we can call. We are on our own. Yes, we have social workers, but guess who they are going to call if something like that happens? The cops. Pat in Elizabethtown, this is where a trained medical person needs to be called, not the police. Perhaps the child needs more intervention than police can provide. On the end of COVID restrictions and Andy Beshear's briefings coming up this Friday. Martha, in Oldham County, Governor Beshear performed above and beyond what we could have expected with intelligence, compassion, and the best interests of Kentuckians in mind. Susan in Bardstown emails the Rant Line. I'm thankful for the COVID-19 updates. For over a year, he's been the voice of reason through some very difficult times. He honored those who passed away and guided us with mandates that I believe saved many lives. You may have different opinions about all this on how the governor handled the COVID shutdowns, which was an experience new to all of us. You are welcome to express your thoughts right here on the Rant Line as we head toward Friday. Post your comments on my Facebook page at WHAS11Doug. I'm also on Twitter at WHAS11Doug. You can follow me there on Twitter if you like. Keep your emails coming to the rant at WHAS11.com. And the toll-free rant line is open. We'll be listening to your calls tonight at 855-749-1101.